Textile fibers. Classification, uses, and examples. Natural fibers. Jim and his friends intend to design t-shirts for a campaign tour against child abuse, a project sponsored by the Partners for International Development, PFID. While Jim is researching on Wikipedia, he meets a fashion designer, Miss Lupita, who agrees to trade her vast knowledge for some cash. They meet now.
Did you bring the money?
Part of it. My mother will send the rest via M-Pesa.
Then I won't give you all the information until... Never mind. These days nothing is for free.
I think I understand.
Good. So where do we begin? You want to be a fashion designer?
In future maybe. As of now, my group wishes to design t-shirts for a project back at home. Problem is, we have no idea how or where to begin. That's why I came.
I see. Expect nothing but the best.
That's assuring. Thank you.
Thank me later, young man. I hope you carried a pen and a notebook. Because what I'm about to discuss has a lot of technical terms which might need to be jotted down for future reference.
Yes, I did.
All right. For starters, you cannot design clothes if you have no knowledge in textile fibers.
And what is that?
Easy. A fiber is a raw material that is used to produce textile finished products. It is a material that can be spun into yarn or processed into textile for making fabric.
I see. So fiber produces fabric, which in turn is used to make clothes. Right?
Essentially. Fibers come in two ways, naturally or man-made. This makes up the two broad classes. Natural fibers are those extracted by natural means from plants, animals, and earth minerals. Mind guessing which plants?
Cotton?
Correct. Cotton, flax, and jute are plants which give us natural fiber, whereas animals such as merino sheep and silkworms produce wool and silk, respectively. And certain rocks of the earth have minerals, asbestos, which are used to manufacture theater curtains and overalls.
Very impressive. So when these natural materials get manufactured in the factory, they become artificial fibers?
Nope. Artificial or man-made fibers are made from polymers, which are chemical substances produced when molecules are reacted with each other repeatedly. Common artificial fibers include nylon, rayon, polyester, and acrylics. However, this class is further subdivided into regenerated fiber such as rayon and synthetic fiber such as nylon and polyester.
Wow. That must require a lot of technology to make.
I am a scientist anyway. Take a look at this flowchart for a better grasp of these groupings of textile fibers. Before you can learn to design clothes, you must learn textile fibers in detail. It forms the foundation for any textile-related career, including design. Cotton is a soft and fluffy fiber that grows in a ball around the seeds of a cotton plant. It is widely grown in China, India, USA, Pakistan, Brazil, and Mexico. It is also produced in some parts of Kenya, Uganda, and Tanzania. Cotton balls are harvested, processed into yarn, which is then spun into a fabric.
Good to know. Which is then used to make clothes.
Yes. The kinds of clothes which are influenced by what cotton is really like.
What does that mean?
It means cotton has certain properties or qualities that makes it suitable for making certain types of clothes. For instance, cotton is highly absorbent fiber, making it great for making towels and sportswear, to absorb excess water and sweat.
Hmm.
It is also strong fiber which can withstand intense washing, thus good for making school uniforms, bed sheets, and aprons. Besides, it can withstand strong detergents and stain removers, thus suited for kitchen clothes and daily wears.
Kitchen clothes are usually washed in hot water to remove dirt and grease. I guess, therefore, cotton can withstand the heat.
Genius! Cotton is resistant to high temperatures, which makes it suitable for making hospital bed sheets, pillowcases, as well as kitchen towels, which require boiling on daily basis to sterilize them. In relation to this, cotton being a good heat conductor becomes great for making warm wares to be put on in cold weather. And, on a light note, cotton does not generate or hold static electricity, which would otherwise make clothes cling to the body. As a result, it is the better option for making underwears.
I see. Are these qualities the reason why cotton is the most commonplace natural fiber?
Perhaps. But there is always two sides to anything, just like the coin.
Meaning?
Negative properties of cotton fiber. For example, cotton creases easily, shrinks, is non-resistant to mildew, or rather, gets damaged under damp conditions and lacks brightness or luster.
Oh, it also gets dirty so readily, making you want to wash them frequently.
Correct. Plus, cotton gets destroyed easily by flames and strong acids.
Oops.
The more reason you should be careful with cotton fabrics such as calico, denim, muslin, khaki, corduroy, and ginger around fire or acids.
Wow, nice piece of information.
I promised the best. You are paying for it after all.
Mm.
Another fiber with similar properties like those of cotton is linen. It is obtained from the stem of flax plant, though. Leading flax producing countries include Canada, Russia, Ukraine, France, Argentina, Italy, and Germany. It is also produced in some African countries such as Egypt, Ethiopia, and South Africa.
No Kenya?
No Kenya, sadly. As I said earlier, linen material is similar to cotton in both properties and uses. Mind a recap?
Like a review?
Mm-hmm.
All right. If they are similar in some ways, then linen is suitable for making underwears, towels, sportswear, uniforms, and warm wears.
Nice summary. Linen is also suitable for making quality blouses, table linen, handkerchiefs, scarves, and household furnishings.
Mm-hmm.
Linen fabrics include damask, crush, linen canvas, cambric, and hookaback.
Hookaback. Sounds Greek.
Nabado. Let's grab a drink.
Fanta.